In the instant case, here the allegation was of incorrect periods of experience mentioned in the certificates. This was sought to be explained by the petitioner through the information given, which has also been alleged in the writ petition. But the fact remains that the verification was carried out by the Medical Council of India and not by the central government. It is in this context that an opportunity by the Medical Council of India was necessary to be given for confronting the petitioner with the material that was to be used in this regard to withdraw the recommendation. The authority to recommend, in our opinion, also inherently in a matter of alleged misrepresentation or fraud possesses the power to withdraw the same. Such power deserves to be read to uphold the object and purpose of the function assigned to an expert body to recommend, namely the Medical Council of India. We cannot be oblivious of the general principles of administrative law in an allegation of fraud or misrepresentation, so as to denude the expert body of its power to withdraw recommendations or treat it to have become fact, even if such a fraud and misrepresentation has been detected. If after such opportunity a finding would have been arrived at, then in that event the endorsement on the declaration given by the petitioner calls as extracted in paragraph 60 of the counter affidavit could have been pressed into service for withdrawal of recommendations. The endorsement without any opportunity to the petitioner by the Medical Council of India would not operate adverse to the petitioner unless the said exercise is ride out. The petitioner no doubt had an obligation to make a correct declaration, but the petitioner should also have the opportunity to explain as to you under what circumstances the certificates of the faculties had been tendered, believing it to be true. Collusion and fraud are not terms of armament. They entail serious consequences, and in such matters where the penalty is harsh, then the observance of the principles of natural justice becomes more necessary. It is for this additional reason as well that we endorse the ratio of the view taken by the full bench of the Delhi High Court to be attracted herein. To us, it appears that the central government also overlooked this aspect of the matter while proceeding to communicate the decision impugned herein dated 29 February 2016. Consequently, for all the reasons given herein above, we find that an opportunity ought to have been given to the petitioner by the Medical Council of India before proceeding to withdraw the recommendation. That having not been done, the recommendation was withdrawn in violation of principles of natural justice, and accordingly the said decision of the Medical Council of India dated 31st January 2016 deserves to be set aside. Since the very foundation of the withdrawal of permission of the central government rests on the withdrawal of the recommendation, consequently the order dated 29 February 2016 passed by the central government cannot be sustained. Both the orders are hereby caused.